I welcome you all with my love and respects. This beautiful book starts with a word, Sri Bhairava Uvacha, means Shiva said. Straight away Shiva is entering into the techniques. He is not giving any intellectual introduction. He is not giving any teachings. Let's enter into the sutra. Then we'll see the meaning. We'll understand it. Sri Bhairava Uvacha Urdve prano hyato jivo visargatma parocharet utpattitvidayastane varanat paridastitihi. Straight he is entering into the subject. He is not giving any intellectual introduction. To tell you honestly, the first spiritual book without introduction. Straight to the point of enlightenment. He is not interested wasting his time. He is not interested in giving you words. He is not interested in giving you any teachings. No teachings. No words. Straight to the subject. Straight to the point of enlightenment. He is not interested in convincing. Let me be honest. All teachings, almost all teachings are given either to convince you that teacher is a great person or to convince himself that what he is believing is something truth. Incident which happened maybe 1 year ago, I went to attend an interreligious conference. In that I was sitting next to a father. I was boasting that I have a training center for meditation teachers in our Bidhi ashram. I said more than 200 people are having the training. He laughed and told me, Swamiji, I have 16 training centers only in Bombay. The conference was in Bombay. Only in Bombay I have 16 training centers. Each training center trains more than 400 preachers. I was shocked. And then I started saying, you will have more people because you guys convert. We don't believe in conversion. Naturally, you will have more people because you convert people. Somehow Sanatana Dharma or Hinduism doesn't believe in conversion. We don't believe in conversion. We believe it is a psychological violence. Conversion is a psychological violence. So I said, because of conversion you may have more people. Then so in course of conversation, after some time he understood that I am teaching meditation and helping people and giving life solutions. He asked me, Swamiji, I want to sit with you privately for some time. I said, you are welcome. He came and we spent more than 1 hour. He was asking some solution for his own personal problems. Anyway, I tried to help him and he was very happy and he's helped. After everything is over, he was about to leave. At the time I asked him, see, one thing is sure, you yourself don't have solution from what you are teaching. Then why are you teaching so aggressively? And I know he teaches, he goes on condemning other religions. See, saying your religion is great is beautiful, nothing wrong. But saying that nothing else is truth, that that's where the problem starts. He goes on condemning. And I know some of the preachers, what they do in India. Let me tell one more story about that later on. Now let me finish this. He goes on condemning all other religions. And I told him, you yourself don't find solution for your own life. Why do you preach so aggressively? By the time he has become very open and he started speaking the truth, he told me, Swamiji, I feel a tremendous fear. What I am preaching is truth or not. I feel completely insecure. But when I see 10,000 people following me, I feel little secured. All 10,000 can't be fools. All 10,000 can't be fools. No, it is true. Please understand. I am saying the truth. He told me this very word. I am feeling the insecurity, Swamiji. But when I see 10,000 people are following me, when I am able to convince 10,000 people, then I feel a little confident. Oh, I can be fool, but 10,000 will not be fool. All 10,000 will not be fool. I was shocked. But understand, this is the truth. Teachings are given either to convince you the teacher is a great person or to convince himself what he is teaching is something great. Only then teachings are given. If there is no need for convincing, only techniques are given. Here, Shiva doesn't have any need. He doesn't have to convince Uma. He doesn't have to convince Devi. He is straight away giving the technique. And let you be very clear, never learn from a person who has to convince about his authority to you. Then he will be talking too many big things which neither you understand nor he himself understands. Because he is in a big job of convincing you. That is why there is a beautiful story, one more story. One great Kashmiri Saivite Pandit, actually this book is from Kashmiri Saivism. The only living religion or the only living tradition which carried the light of Shaiva, light of Shaivism, the light of Shiva till today. Kashmiri Saivite Pandit, he went to the king and said, King, I wanted to teach you the Shiva Sutras and I want to initiate you. King said, I don't feel like having it. First you read and then come to me. Pandit was taken aback. And he said, I have read for the last 12 years. I have mastered it completely. King again said, no, go back and read. Then come. After 6 months, Pandit again came. Now I wanted to teach you. Now I read everything. King said, no. Go back. Read a little more. Then come. After 6 months, again the Pandit came. King said, no. Go back and practice. Then come. Pandit was shocked. He started thinking, I think somewhere I am missing. He went and started practicing. After 6 months, he did not come back to the king. He was sitting in his place, blissfully. Then king said, please go and find out what has happened to the Pandit. All the servants of the king came to the Pandit and they said, sir, are you not coming to the king? Are you not coming to the palace to teach? Pandit said, no, I'm not interested. No, I don't feel like. And king said, yes, now I can go and learn from him. Now it is time. Now he is ripe. I can go and learn from him. Now, Pandit doesn't have any need to convince the king about his greatness. If there is a need to convince the disciple, if there is a need to convince the student, be very clear, truth cannot be expressed 100%. If already the bridge trust has happened, then sharing the truth is possible. I always tell people, do not think to doubt you need intelligence. To doubt you don't need intelligence, just intellect is enough. Yesterday, one devotee was asking me, what is this, Swamiji? Always you encourage doubting and questioning. But suddenly you change the whole trend. Yesterday you started telling, only fools doubt, only fools question. See, doubting, questioning is good to learn, but not to experience. If you just want to learn, if you want more and more words, if you want teachings, doubting is beautiful. Questioning is beautiful. But when it comes to techniques, doubting or questioning is not going to help. Straight away, if you want the experience, only the trust can help you. I always tell people, when intellect is ripe, it becomes intelligence. When emotion ripes, it becomes trust. When your being ripes, it becomes enlightenment. If your intellect has reached its peak, it becomes intelligence. If your emotion has reached its peak, it becomes trust. If your being has reached its peak, it becomes enlightenment. To doubt, you don't need intelligence, just intellect is enough. You can doubt anything. And the more you doubt, the more you question, people will start respecting you. It's the truth. If you just wanted to show yourself as a great person, simply start doubting everybody, start criticizing everybody. It's a beautiful technique. Start criticizing everybody, start doubting everybody, start questioning everybody. You will become a great pundit. People will start respecting you. Here, no teachings, straight away enters into the technique. He is not even saying, now I am starting meditation techniques. Even that much he is not saying. Straight to the technique. He says, start doing it. He is not speaking about anything else. No introduction, no teachings. Yesterday,